tell us a bit about what fans can expect from the new record.
11 songs that we think are the dog's bollocks, better than anything else that's out there. Great melodies, good songs, good vocals, good playing. Beautiful.
We spent 5 weeks in Richmond with Dave Sitek. He is a native of LA, hardly ever leaves his compound, and he came to Richmond to impress us with his audio skills.
To burn sage.
Yeah.
And eat cakes.
So we sent him home with a thirst for acoustic guitars.
So it sounds quite different from
what people know. It's not an album that we expected to come out with at all. We went in there with a load of songs, really rehearsed up, and then Dave came in, not having rehearsed before. He brought something really new to it, and I don't think any of us expected what came out. Like, it just kind of was a marriage of two worldviews that were pretty complementary to each other in the end.
What are your favourite standout tunes that really really define what the, you know, if you could say what defines
the record? Finger, Second Bite of the Apple,
Soul Love.
I mean, they're not as an album, it's a really good fucking collection of songs, and it works well together. If you take one off, I know we said that last time, and it'd all fall apart. But I don't know, it's all good, man. All complimentary.
Like, it's like we were demoing and stuff, and sort of finishing and writing. Because it's all pretty much new since the last record. So we got to like August, and we did a couple of gigs with Stone Roses, and at that point we had 12 tunes. So we were thinking, oh, we're going after this and do the album, and then we kind of thought twice about it and decided to go back and write more. And that's when we got some of the best ones. Flick of the Finger was really late on in it, although that had its sort of roots in a demo that Liam and Gem made like years ago. But we've completely reworked it, wrote words for it, put horns on it, did all that, and that's kind of one of the first times we've collaborated on the writing of a tune.
And like, Flick of the Finger is the one you're kicking off with, right?
Yeah. Yes.
First thing people are going to hear.
Yeah, it's fucking in your face, stomping, I don't know what to call it, it's just mental. I think, but it sounds to me it's like a tsunami just waiting to fucking come at you, and then it gets you, and then you're fucked.
So yeah, that's how we had it when we were kind of, it's like Bruce Lee on a surfboard on a tsunami.
Yeah,
with brass
burning sage. A lot more magic on this record
experiment
than there was on Different Gears Still Speeding. I don't think, to be quite honest, there was any magic on that, but that's not saying I'm putting it down. It was just pretty much straightforward kind of thing. This one's got sprinkled with magic, and that, you know, and you're lucky if that ever happens on any record in your lifetime. So I think hopefully people will be able to smell and see and hear the magic, you know what I mean? It's sprinkled with magic, this one, I think.
The main immediate difference is like the way Liam's voice has been mixed.
Yeah, man. Well, that's, I'm sick of fucking idiots saying I can't sing, you know what I mean? So I thought, fuck this, no effects. No, double tracking as much, you know what I mean? Let's get in there bare. This is how I sound, man. That's how I sound around the fucking house, you know, on the back of a camel, you know, whatever, you know what I mean? This is how my voice sounds, so hopefully people will like it and get off my fucking back.
But so, I mean, is there plans to do, you know, with the brass on Flick and Finger, you're going to get some brass involved?
Yeah. Always up for getting the brass in.
You know.
Especially him. Yeah, it's a horny little record, man.
And what's exciting you, music or otherwise, at the minute?
Apart from this?
Yeah.
Justin Bieber for me, man. Yeah, he's the one to watch out. Anyone who goes on 2 fucking hours late is fucking right in my book, man. All these so-called rock bands that sit about backstage going, hey, let's wait 15 minutes. Well, let's fucking wait. Yeah, you got to wait 2 hours and 15 minutes. He's kicked the fucking ass out of it, man. And no one will beat that. So fucking get off his back, man. I am a believer. Well, the album's called B.
B letter B or B E?
No, B E.
The word.
Which kills two stones, two things with one stone.
Two Bs
with one stone. And it's called B, and it's just
a fucking good shot.
And we just, yeah, but it's just called B, innit?
It's called B.
What's the thinking behind that?
Nothing, not a lot.
You tell me.
Not a lot, man. We didn't really think about it.
Of course we know.
Well, my theory is it's going to have B on the front fucking cover, and on the back cover, I'm going to put fucking IEBER on it, on the slide.
So you're not infused by much rock music going on?
No, not at all, man. No. No one's
it's
doing
hard, man.
But that's just my personal opinion. The guys get out there and they say, what's going on
here, man? Soon get back in.
Yeah.
So you're looking
forward? I think this will kickstart something, man. I've got a feeling, man. I mean, like, we're really, really confident about it.
Yeah.
It might kickstart something. Our scientists will become more and more deadly until they can, with the flick of the finger, tear a million of you to pieces.
Why is it all about Justin Bieber?
I don't fucking know. I was better than going on about the fucking stripes and fucking all them motherfuckers.